We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Pimps in the crib, ma. Drop it like it's hot.
Welcome to
drop
LA like Talk Live. My name is James Kinney, and this is the James Kinney Show. Hello, world. Hello, Periscope. Hello, Facebook. Hello, Twitter. Hello, Instagram. And hello, like Adele from the other side.
Hello, hello. Lala.
Yes. Yes. I am joined today by my amazing co-host, Amber Valdez, Life Purpose Cheerleader. And of course, Kelsey Berryhill from Purse Case. It's going to be an exciting show today. Amber, what's good?
What's good? Well, I just want to first say thank you so much for giving me an opportunity to be here at LA Talk Live for the first show of the James Kinney Show. Whoop, whoop.
Thank you very much.
Yes. So I want to introduce you, James.
Well, hold on. Let me introduce you first because I'm a southern gentleman. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Amber Valdez. She has been in broadcasting for over 10 years, featured on ABC's Beverly Hills Nanny. She was a Seattle Seahawks cheerleader, and guess what? She was the only one without dance training. She went on YouTube, and she took dance lessons. I'm just kidding. She taught herself how to be a bad star dancer, and then made the Seattle Seahawks. And because she was the Seattle Seahawks dancer, they actually won the Super Bowl. So Russell Wilson gets to thank Amber Valdez, and she's the co-host of the James Kinney Show. A lot more coming up about Amber later on in the show.
Go Hawks. Thank you so much for that amazing intro. Wow, that was the first. It's all because of me.
Because of you.
Thank you guys so much. So I'm getting told I need to move closer to my mic.
Okay.
Rookie mistake. Oh my God, I sound so good now.
Yes, on that mic.
So you guys, I want to take this opportunity to introduce the man of the hour, the James Kinney of the James Kinney Show himself. This human being is on a mission to work hard, love hard, play hard, and teach hard, if that makes any sense.
Yeah.
But James is the author of an amazing book. He also does everything in his power to become an incredible human being. He is a fantastic singer, musician, and overall BAD. Can I cuss on the radio?
Can we curse?
Can I say the A-S?
Ah,
badass. He's badass. But he's been featured on NBC Smart Money. This man, I think he's like a walking business guru. So anytime I can sit next to him and just absorb some of his amazing knowledge, I'm all about it. So I'm fired up today. Thank you, James, for who you are in this world. And I'm just excited to play with you. This is awesome.
Thank you, Amber. This is a lot of fun. Thank you for that introduction. And we have a special guest in the audience tonight in the house and in the audience. I guess that's both. This is a good friend of mine, Kelsey Berryhill. Kelsey Berryhill is the Vice President of Retail Services for Purse Case, which is a Shark Tank featured brand. And also, they're about to debut on ABC television as well for Beyond the Tank.
Beyond the Tank.
Yeah, April 26th at 10 p.m.
Yeah. And a few other notes about Kelsey. She is a music fiend. She's a workout fiend. She's a spiritual lady. So she's what Amber would I call a conscious commerce badass as well. For sure.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And you know, the first time that I met you, and I said this to your dad, first time I met him, I said, she's the hardest working woman I know. Like, crazy hustler, and to scale a company from nothing to where you guys are now is incredible. So congratulations, Kelsey, on your personal and professional success.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Yeah. So welcome to the show. Well, ladies and gentlemen out there in internet world, this is the point of the show where we're about to get loose, because we got to loosen you guys up as an audience so you know what to happen. So Richard and Elliot, would you guys bless us with like 1 minute of something crazy that we can break it down to?
Oh, boy.
You guys ready to see us boogie?
Yeah, let's.
I'm ready to boogie.
Let's boogie. Oh!
Can you stand up?
As long as I guess it's almost still on camera. Get loose in the. Get loose in the.
Share dance. Shout out to the Perry family.
Share dance.
Let's go.
Okay.
West Coast. You know, I got in trouble for throwing up West Coast at a Seahawks game once.
Did you?
Because
it was gang.
Huge trouble.
Alleged gang language.
They said no gang signs at the game.
No gang signs.
I got in T-R-O-U-B-L-E.
Yeah, so one of their cheerleaders was allegedly a gangster, right?
That's right.
That makes a lot of sense.
West Coast forever.
I think there's like regulations and then there's like over regulations.
Yeah, that's kind of Amber doing whatever wants to do, you know?
We're going to get into politics here in a little bit.
I hope you guys are dancing with us. I can't see you all, but I hope you're dancing.
I feel you.
I'm going to show them what you guys are doing. Show, work it out, James. Work it out. Show the Perry family some love.
On a mission for them. Lean money, make it. Make it.
Yeah,
I've been in the game for
years, making
rap tunes.
Oh, we got a caller. Oh, my goddess. Yay, our first caller. And you guys, please, if you guys want to call in, 323-473-3100.
Welcome to the James Kinney Show. Who's live on the line right now?
Hi, this is your great friend from college, Lauren Taylor.
Lauren Taylor in the building.
What's going on, guys?
What's up? Lauren, please meet Amber and Kelsey, who are live on the air with you.
Yay, Lauren.
Hello.
Hey, guys. How's it
What's
going?
What's up? Thank you for calling. Your first caller, the first Kinney Show. How exciting is this?
Lauren, it's so good to hear your voice. It's kind of funny that we've been best friends for like 23 years, and it takes a live internet broadcast to get us on the phone together.
Lauren, tell us all the dirt
terrible.
On James.
Yeah, we don't have a long enough show.
Got him.
The clip notes.
Well, and you probably don't want to know what we would really be talking about if it was just the two of us. So we'll try to keep
snap.
It, you know, more generic.
So, keep it
there are children watching.
So, Lauren, so you said that you're at a tostada taqueria right now with Mexican music playing, right?
Yeah, well, I was. I just left because I couldn't. It was like all this crazy. You guys had something going on. They had something going on. So I just walked out so that I could hear you better.
Oh, well, thank you for calling in. Well, just to let you know what we're going to be talking about on the show today, for those of you guys who don't know Lauren Taylor, if you have any real estate needs in the city of Houston, or in the state of Texas, because her license is throughout the state.
That's right, James. I sell ranches, too.
Yes, exactly. And I'm working on my ranch.
Perfect.
Yeah, my ranch back in Texas. But Lauren is a real estate expert, not just an agent, but a actual investor, a flipper, a home builder. Anything and everything in terms of equity or homes, Lauren is the person to contact. Lauren, how do people get in touch with you?
Well, you can call my cell phone if you want. I'm all over the internet. Lauren Taylor, Houston Real Estate. You can find me really easily.
So we can call you on your cell phone.
Later. Late night when you what? Need my love.
We were singing Drake. We were singing Drake to you. We can call you on your cell phone.
You totally can.
Awesome. Well, Lauren, thanks so much for calling in. Is there anything else that you would like to say today? How were the tacos?
Well, the tacos were great. I've never been to a taqueria that only has tostadas, and it was delicious.
Yeah.
So what are y'all talking about today on the show?
Today we're going to talk about God in the context of Rihanna being a number one artist on the charts and her thanking God. We're going to talk about Donald Trump in politics and the impact that he's having in politics. So make sure to stay tuned.
Well, I will.
Awesome.
Good to talk to you, James. Talk to you later.
You too. I love you. I'll speak to you soon.
Love you. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Felicia.
Caller number two, you are now live on the air, the James Kinney Show, with myself, Amber Valdez, and Kelsey Berryhill. Who are we speaking to, and where are you calling from?
Hi, this is Dave from Ohio.
Hey, Dave from Ohio. What's up?
Hey, you're calling in from Periscope?
Yes, I am.
Amazing. Right. Amazing. So
you guys are awesome, man. You guys
thank you.
Just keep it up. You inspire me.
Oh.
You guys inspire a lot.
Thanks so much. Well, tell us about you, man.
Well, I live in Ohio, about 5 houses from the lake.
Ooh.
And I'll be leaving for Fiji in about 2 weeks. I'm going to be buying a home down there.
Wow. Making us jealous.
And I caught Amber's scope probably about a week ago, and I've been following her ever since. And
as you should.
It's an awesome day because she has you and everyone else. It's just an outstanding day.
Yeah. That, you know, if we so choose it to see it like that, right? And that's one of the things that Amber does so well. I totally agree with you, Dave. I sent Amber a message a few weeks ago, and I said, you know what? You are just one of the best humans I've ever met, period. So aww. I only concur with how awesome Amber is, and I'm thankful that you joined us from her scope.
Aww, thank
calling in. You rock. Thank you for the support.
This is the my Perry family. I'm listening to you, but you're pretty cool yourself.
Thank you so much.
Like attracts like. Mirror,
thank you
mirror.
So much. Hey, well, Dave, we have another caller calling in, but thanks so much for reaching out to us. Make sure to check us every Wednesday at 2 p.m. Pacific. You're in Ohio. Is it 5 for Eastern time for you, or is it 4?
No, it's Eastern time.
Eastern time. Okay, so 5 o'clock for you.
All right, I'll be going back on to Amber Sculpt here, so you guys have a very good day.
Thanks so much for calling in, Dave.
Thanks.
You thank you. Okay, bye.
Caller number 3, welcome to the James Kinney Show, hosted by me, James, Amber Valdez, and Kelsey Berryhill. Who are we speaking to, and where are you calling in from?
You are speaking with Sam Ebel, calling from Atlanta, Georgia. How are we doing today?
ATL!
Sam! ATL in the building. Outcast.
Woo! ATL
is my favorite
in the house.
Yes, 404. The SWAT.
404.
How are you? I saw that you called my phone twice, so I said, call me on the radio.
Yeah, I know. Well, I'd rather just air it all out while I'm live, you know, just like get it all out there, guys. What's going on?
Going. Everything's good. We're in California. How's Atlanta?
I gotta put this up.
Atlanta is great. Atlanta is fantastic.
So what do you have to air out on the radio?
Oh, I love it. I love it. I love it. So, and go ahead. Go ahead.
No, I'm just saying. So, Sam, tell us about yourself.
So my name is Sam Ebel. The way I know these girls, I gotta tell you, and I'm sure you guys have already gone over this, but they are fantastic. Some of the best entrepreneurs I've ever met.
True.
Even regardless of age. And I actually told Kelly last week that I would like to make a t-shirt or get a t-shirt made with her face on it. But I'm actually in the process of doing it. And I think all your listeners should know this and get ready to order it live. And we'll send you the link when we get that up. But she's just a hero for all entrepreneurs, you know, regardless of age or gender. But additionally, female entrepreneurs and young entrepreneurs as well.
I totally agree. I totally agree. They are the entrepreneur's entrepreneur. Yes, like the musician's musician.
They are.
I agree. Richard, we have one more caller. Go ahead. Hey, well, Sam, thanks so much for calling in. Sorry to keep it short. We have one more caller. Oh, sorry, the other caller dropped, so we'll stick with Sam. So, Sam, so you are a huge fan of the Purse Case badass entrepreneurs that they are. Tell us some more about you.
I would say I'm one of the number one groupies. You know, I made sure my sister has one, uh-huh. My mom has one. I have a company myself. It's called Good Wipes, and we do you know, body wipes for when you can't shower, for those traveling busy people on the go, camping,
yeah,
Coachella, all that good stuff. And we make some other products too. And these girls have just given me so much insight with their experience. It's just, you know, it's really about them. It's just been great.
Amazing. Cool.
What a sweetheart. Yeah. It turns it always back on us.
Yeah.
Such a good thing.
I mean, I can't control it. It's where my mind goes.
Awesome. Well, thank you for the love.
Yeah, well, thanks so much. Well, thank you so much for calling in. Make sure to follow all of us on social so we can follow you back, Sam.
Absolutely. Purse case. One love.
Thanks.
Love everybody.
Thanks so much, man. Love you. And I believe we need to take a short commercial break right now to pay some bills. And when we come back, we're going to get in our topics for the day. This is the James Kinney Show, live on LA Talk Live with Amber Valdez and Kelsey Berryhill. We'll see you guys in a moment.
Be mindful.
on the scene, I'm hearing hoochie screaming, fiending for money and alcohol, for life of a Westside player with Cali's eye and a strong ball. Only in Cali will we play and not rally to live and die. In LA we wear chucks, not valleys. Yeah, that's right. Dressed in loafs and khaki suits and ride is what we do. Flossing but have caution, we collide with other troops. Famous because we program. Worldwide, let them recognize from Long Beach to Rosecrans. Bumping and grinding like a slow jam. It's Westside, so you know I'm going to bow down the new man. Say what you say, but give me that bomb beat from Dre. Let me serenade the streets of LA. From Oakland to Sacktown, the Bay Area and back down. Cali is where they put their Mac down. Give me love.
Choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Designs by Ardina, preserving heritage and building legacies through art. Turn your favorite photos into personalized, one-of-a-kind, customized artwork. Designs by Ardina offers innovative and creative options for printing on aluminum, acrylic, canvas, with custom framing and matting services available upon request. Designs by Ardina also offers photo restoration, portrait art, digital photo albums, and even basic business printing services. For more information and a customized quote, visit www.designsbyardina.com. That's www.designsbyardina.com. Or call 323-455-1251. That's 323-455-1251. Designs by Ardina, proud sponsors of LA Talk Live and the Talk Live Broadcast Network.
Hi, this is Frank.
And this is Ruslan.
Inviting you to join us every Thursday, 1 p.m. Pacific, for Cool Classics.
Join us as we discuss classical cool in the arts, what has happened, what is happening, and what will happen.
So don't forget to tune in to Cool Classics
every Thursday, 1 p.m. Pacific,
exclusively on LATalkLive.com.
You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B, Radio Flag, TuneIn Radio, AHA Radio, TiVo Radio, and Apple TV Radio.
Or just watch and listen directly at Cool Classics on LATalkLive.com.
Classic radio handcrafted for your listening and viewing.
This is LA Talk Live,
and this is Frank,
and this is Ruslan,
and we are more than just talk.
In all the clubs you get in using my name, you think you broke my heart, oh girl, for goodness sake. You think I'm crying on my own, well I ain't.
Welcome back to the James Kinney Show on LA Talk Live, where we are more than just talk. Wonderful to be back here. It's been quite some time. Special thanks to Richard Carr, owner of the studio, as well as Elliot. Thanks so much for being here today. Arian, who you guys can't see, who's behind the camera, thank you for being my little bro and getting us some additional footage. Amber Valdez, my sister, thank you so much. And Kelsey, the entrepreneur's entrepreneur, thank you for being here. So let's get into some topics and current topics. For those of you guys who don't know, what we're covering here on the James Kinney Show is current topics, news, politics, but we're going to put a little twist to it. And really, when people go on CNN, Fox, etc., it's so much of just rhetoric and over again, mm-hmm. and it usually winds up in a negative place, or I feel like a lot of times traditional news media tries to steer it in a negative direction. So we're going to do a little bit new style and different here and take things in a more soulful, spiritual, bright, sunny direction. I mean, we are Southern Californians.
That's right.
You know, we're going to be objective, but we're going to give you guys the real.
Cool.
Right. So I was reading a story in the airport in San Francisco the other day about Rihanna had made some comments. Her song "Work," which I love it.
Work, 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 work.
Yes, that's a jam. By the way, I think it was great for her to go back to her roots of the Caribbean. Like even hearing her sing in the accent, I really like it. Yeah. Anyhow, so she thanked God on Twitter for being 7 weeks at number one, and Joyce Meyer, who's a huge female preacher, she even gave her a shout out on Twitter, and she made comments that specifically her success is because of God, and that her faith is what keeps her on top and keeps her striving. So there was some feedback and some comments about, you know, can a sex icon, which Rihanna's wore naked dresses before, you ladies can weigh in on that, but for someone who's a sex icon and a pipe icon, can she also be an icon of God? So what do you guys think, Amber?
Well, I feel 100% she can be, because I believe God is a God loves everyone, right? Mm-hmm. God, the God that I love and the God that I know to be true, is a forgiving and an all encompassing God. So of course she would thank him if she's a believer in a higher power and something in someone bigger than her. Of course she's going to go ahead and give credit where credit is due. Mm-hmm. And I think it's beautiful. And I don't think God judges anyone. And in my opinion, as long as you're not out there killing, robbing, stealing, and hurting the planet, I don't really see why anyone would have any problems with her thanking whoever in her life has made the biggest impact. So.
Yeah. I definitely agree with that. Caller, what's your name? Where are you from? And we're going to let you introduce yourself, but we're going to hear from Kelsey, and then we'll hear from you.
Hi, I'm Hannah, and I am from Sarasota, California.
Hey, Hannah.
Hey, Hannah. What's up?
Homegirl, we're back home heroes, baby. This is one of my best friends from high school.
Oh, amazing.
So, hey, Hannah.
Cool.
Yeah, hey, I'm glad you called. And I just have to say, Hannah absolutely loves Rihanna. I mean, diehard fan.
Yeah, definitely my favorite artist for sure.
So, Hannah, what are your thoughts? I mean, do you think Rihanna can talk about religion and still be a sex symbol?
I think, honestly, Rihanna could do whatever she wants and just run with it.
Work, 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 work.
Riri.
Yeah.
As long as she works it, then she's good.
Yeah.
I would definitely agree with that.
She's beautiful.
I mean, she is. And, it comes down to being a businesswoman and sex sells, and she's built a brand around her body and how she delivers herself, and I think it's totally fine. And religion's a personal issue. You know, it's really not anyone's opinion to weigh on how she decides to believe in. She's built a brand. She's a businesswoman, so I praise her.
Yeah, I think God gave her that body. So.
Yeah, exactly.
She is embracing her divine, sacred, feminine goddess power. And
that was a real yeah.
All right,
will you say that again, Amber?
Rihanna is embracing her sacred, feminine goddess power.
Mm-hmm.
Word.
Oh my God, I
fall
agree.
In love with
We're gonna
mic.
Quote
totally
that.
Agree.
Yes. Yeah. So good for you, girl.
Yeah, I agree. And I think to further the issue, I think that the media often creates too much out of something. I think that we have a tendency in this country to be very myopic in how we receive our heroes, our icons, and people that we look up to in the marketplace. So just because someone is a politician doesn't mean that they can't play basketball or play the guitar. Just because someone is a famous pop star like Rihanna doesn't mean that she can't have a strong faith. So 100%. I think that we are dynamic as people. And I think that the mass media, and I think public opinion as well, should allow individuals to have expression of multiple things. So, for example, Kelsey is a great entrepreneur, but there's a lot more to Kelsey than just being a great entrepreneur. So why can't you be a great yogi? Why can't you be good at math? Why can't you...
Oh, I'm terrible at math, so don't give me that credit.
Okay.
But yes, I do love me some yogi and some spirituality, and it comes down to a lot more than just work. And
work.
Exactly.
Yeah. So Hannah, tell us about you.
I just graduated from UC Santa Barbara.
Mm-hmm. Congrats.
And I just started work up in the Bay Area. And I've been doing that for about a month now, and I played volleyball at Santa Barbara.
Yes.
So that's about it for right now.
Volleyball. She's got a Rihanna Bump body.
Set spike. Oh. Win tonight.
You know.
That was amazing. I like
that. Hey, what, Hannah, as Drake would say, if you had a twin, I would still choose you.
That's my favorite part, man. Yeah.
Seriously.
I know. Awesome. Well, Hannah, thanks
so
much.
Have you guys seen the video?
Yes.
Yeah, watched it last night. It was actually the first time.
There's two of them.
Yes. I've seen the full. Yeah.
Yeah, you mean the one was just the Rihanna video and Drake being a creeper. Yeah. And the other video was beautiful. I totally am in alignment with what Jane shared about her taking it back to her roots with her accent, mm-hmm. just the way she moved. And I think that Drake should have wore something else because everyone looks so dope in that video. The styling was on point.
And he's wearing like Tim's.
But he was wearing like his cheesy sweat getup.
Drake, though.
It was like OVO.
Yeah, I was like, come on, man. Yeah. Everyone's dressing so cool. Can't you just join the party?
Yeah. Well, Hannah, if you'd like to stay on and wage some more opinions, you're more than welcome to. But we're going to move on to topic number two for today. So,
okay,
going back to
I'm going to get back to work, but talk to you guys.
Love you, Hannah. Thank you for
calling. Are you going to get back to work? Or are you going to get back to work?
you don't know. I don't know either.
Go back into work dancing like Riri.
Yeah.
Bring some joy in there.
All right. See you guys.
All right. Bye. Thanks so much.
We know there are.
So next, guys, you know, going back to the Ferguson, which was about a year and a half, a year and three quarters ago, there's been a lot of conversations and a lot of discussions around, is police brutality something that is happening more frequently now, or is it something that because of social media, cell phone video footage, and the internet and the news, that it's just more prevalent and in our face? Because through American history, we can go back from the earliest of times, and police brutality and abuse has been around for quite some time. So there's been a divide between the communities in which they serve and the communities in which they operate. But do you guys think that it's more prevalent now, or do you think that it's literally just the fact that everyone has a cell phone? Amber? Oof.
You know, that's hard to say because, once again, we didn't have that amazing, beautiful gift of cellular devices where we can just really capitalize on all of it now. I mean, at the end of the day, like, the whole situation is getting so out of control, and it's actually quite sad and scary because I believe we're going and shifting into a place and a paradigm where everyone's really recognizing that it's not cool to be racist. It's not cool to talk badly about others, to hurt others. Like, I really believe we're shifting into a place where we're all one and we all are getting it. And so it really scares me sometimes when I see us going backwards. And it makes me very nervous. Because, you know, I was doing my research, you know, to speak upon this. And as we get into, you know, these really, you know, sensitive topics. And you brought up the yogi thing the other day. And I was reading about this woman who's starting this movement. And it stemmed off of the Black Lives Matter. And I really just feel like all lives matter. And we've gotten, you know, and I'm blessed to live in Los Angeles, and I've lived in New York, and I don't experience racism where I live. I don't experience racism here. I don't experience racism on television. There's so many predominant African-American hosts. There's so many predominant African-Americans. Our president is African-American. We live in such an awesome time where I do feel like everybody has the same chance to do whatever it is that they want, especially now in 2016. So when people start, I feel like when they put themselves in a box, and this woman started this movement about black yogis, and it's like making up a story about how there's not enough black yogis in the world, and this and this and that. And I was just like, what is she talking about? Because my yoga instructor is a black man. Okay. And I never even thought about Pagan as like a black guy. He's just my yogi. He's my yoga instructor. And there's tons of African-American people that practice yoga in Los Angeles and where I live. So when people
and I'm one of them.
You. So it's like, why not? Let's create a movement for yoga, not just a movement for black people doing yoga. Like, if I don't care if I'm Asian, if I'm Indian, if I'm whatever I am, Hispanic. If I want to do yoga, I'm going to do yoga. And I feel like it's one of those things where let's stop like putting ourselves in a space where we're creating distance between one another.
I agree. The key word there is inclusion.
Yes,
absolutely.
And I believe we have a caller.
Yeah, this is a Cali sportsman representing LA Talk Live. You're doing good there, man. It's a nice show. It's real exciting. But I wanted to kind of touch on that little point there, because I think if you look at the most current situation in L.A. where these kids was doing donuts in a drop-top Mustang, I think it become more of a socioeconomic issue. I mean, even listening to Amber talk about, you know, when you're successful, you know, we have a tendency not to see, you know, we have a tendency to see probably a little bit more diversity and people getting along and getting together. But I think what's happening is that it's a socioeconomic thing when it comes to just, you know, people that are a little less fortunate don't really get a lot of opportunity. It's kind of the ones who sought out as being the bad folks. And unfortunately, you know, it's kind of like the society we live in. It's, you know, it's people got money, people don't have money, and it's just not fair across the board.
Right.
Certainly, I would agree that everything that we're looking at in terms of, if you go back to pre-Vietnam era, post-World War II. So post-World War II, the industrialization of America, the distribution of wealth was a lot more equal. Mm-hmm. And you had black communities, Jewish communities, Asian communities, Hispanic communities, et cetera, but everyone had a piece of the pie. Post-Vietnam and John F. Kennedy during the Civil Rights Movement, I would agree, the distribution of socioeconomics changed dramatically. And with that scarcity, whether it's economic scarcity or mental scarcity, things shifted. And I think that the ubiquitousness of technology, right, in the technology world, that wasn't distributed as equally, potentially, to certain socioeconomic and demographic groups. But I think that as technology continues to grow, all socioeconomic and demographic groups have the opportunity to take advantage of those technologies to level the playing field. Because I saw a yes?
And I say you're probably touching on that point when you look at the entrepreneurship we see today
right.
through technology or something as simple as Uber. There are these other scenarios where people will be able to create residual dollars for themselves
right.
to be able to play on the same playing field as someone of a real true entrepreneur yes. to, you know, that has the millions and millions of dollars. So
yeah.
I think it will evolve. I think the other problem that we see in our community is that we're probably since the 80s, when you look at the crack era, we're looking at almost a second generation of kids who basically become chemical dependent. So
yes.
When you look at those two aspects in certain communities, and you know, you just hope for the best that the next set of kids that come out of this, you know, can really, really continue to keep a future for you know, keep, you know, especially when we're talking Latino and black communities.
Yeah, and you know, and I'd like to say there was an article that came out about 3 weeks ago where one of the chief advisors to the Reagan administration finally admitted that there was an absolutely strategic plan to incarcerate black and Latin American unproportionately to everyone else.
Wow.
And he said it on his deathbed, but it's all documented.
The tell all.
Yeah.
Well, I think it's time that we go ahead.
No, I'm just saying, and you look at now people have got hot houses and distribution centers all around the, you know, the country more or less, but just say that on the West Coast who making millions and millions of dollars, and you look in the 80s and 90s of all the folks that actually sold drugs, specifically marijuana pot, are locked up in jail for 25 years.
Sure, of course. And of course, I mean, we're not condoning drug dealing, but to your point, I do understand that not too long ago, if you were selling pot, you could get 20 years in prison. Mm-hmm. But now, as society continues to change, pot is used for health and pot is used for good, and it's people who have pot houses.
Great show, man. Thanks for having me.
Thanks so much. Thanks for calling in. And we have another caller on the air. This is the James Kinney Show. What's your name and where are you calling from?
Hi, my name is Desiree Lee, and I'm calling from Atlanta, Georgia.
Desiree! Yay! I was just that point right there. Hi, Desiree. When he was talking about that, we don't want to get into your story, or we can, but I was just like thinking like he's dead on about Desiree and what it looks like to be locked up for a very long time for something very, very silly from a long, long, long time ago, depending on what part of the world you used to live in and what part of states.
Mm-hmm.
Desiree, do you want to weigh in on this topic that we're speaking of right here, right now?
Absolutely. The laws are pretty hefty. I'm speaking from personal experience. 17 years old at the time, 3.8 GPA, grade point average, 2 basketball scholarships, in a really nice, predominantly neighborhood where I was living at. Good family, good home. and of one costly decision because I wanted to be cool. 2 weeks after I graduated from high school, I was incarcerated for 11 counts of armed robbery and 5 counts of aggravated assault.
Wow.
And so for that, I was facing 135 years in prison at 17, just for being the driver in Georgia. And, of course, that is a hefty, hefty penalty, especially at that age where we make careless decisions as teenagers. We do. Mm-hmm. I'm not putting the blame on anyone else, but I think the price I had to pay for that decision was not warranted for what I did on that day. And so I was sentenced to 10 years to serve 4 years in prison, and there's only 5 states that if you commit a crime as such that you get charged as an adult. So at 17, I was in an adult facility for being a driver in the car.
That's insane. Well, I'm so happy that you're out. And the documentation of the for-profit prison system is just so out there in the public now. And mm-hmm. I think of the Fortune 1000 publicly traded companies, there's more, I think there's 7 or 8 of them that are the privately held, well, not private as in public or private, but they are for-profit publicly traded prison systems. So there's absolutely a business of incarceration, and it's disproportionate to certain citizens, for sure.
And it's so cool that Desiree, I mean, she's so inspiring. She's written a few books, and now, you know, her book, she goes and speaks all over the country. Judges actually buy 500 books of hers at a time and give them out to kids in these underprivileged areas to really teach them of what that looks like when you make those decisions. It's not so much the jail time. It's what happens when you get out. And over 6 years, she struggled trying to get hired everywhere, and no one would hire her because of her. And it's one of those systems where we really just need to focus on the system.
Yeah.
And we need to focus on the education.
Broken systems,
and
I
it's
agree.
Like keep thank God someone like Desiree was able to become an entrepreneur
and
take her pain, turn it into purpose, and you know the rest is history. But that's one of those ways where we're so grateful to live in this time and space, and no matter what your color, no matter where you live, you can make a business doing what you love.
Yeah, it's just all like about making opportunities for yourself. And I think that's something that also, bringing it back to technology, is technology allowed a lot of people to create opportunities.
Yes.
So it's a really powerful thing, and it can be good and it can be bad, but for, you know, a situation where someone needs to get their story out, like yourself, it's amazing. Technology really can push things that people need to see out there.
Yeah. You know, in
absolutely.
You know, and in correlation to you as well, and the gentleman in the call before, there was a Vice Media documentary on Kendrick Lamar.
Mm-hmm.
They were in South Central, and they went deep into what it's like to be from South Central. And even though South Central is only 15 to 20 minutes from here,
mm-hmm.
how it can feel like a completely different planet. But through technology, a simple microphone and a laptop computer, there were guys in the back of a barbershop that were making albums. And there was even a 14-year-old kid who has his own LA Talk Live kind of station in a restaurant.
That is amazing.
In the back of a restaurant. So literally, when you talk about just straight up business, they have, you know, product development, they have marketing, they have distribution, all because of the same technology tools that everyone else has. Mm-hmm. And that's awesome.
I love it.
Yeah.
I love awesome. It.
Absolutely. It definitely takes someone to continue to believe
mm-hmm.
That, you know, hope is still alive and opportunities still present itself. It's just being ready mm-hmm. to take hold of it and just go for it. And that's what happened for me. Even though you're right, technology, everything is there right in front of us. And even with a young boy in the back of the restaurant, it's the restaurant owners or someone whoever allowed him to do that mm-hmm. still believes that, hey, look, let's use what you have until you can do better.
It's so cool.
I like that. Yeah. Use what you have until you can do better. I'm going to personally use that and take that with me if that's okay with you, Desiree.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you so much for having me on, Amber. I love you.
I love you.
And let's just continue to believe in each other again.
Yes, and you guys, Dee Lee, she is the author hacker. She became a friend of mine on Periscope.
Amazing.
And she coaches people to turn their books, turn their business ideas and their book ideas into ebooks in 24 hours. So
that's
check
amazing.
Her out. What is it? DeeLeeInspires.com. I'm plugging you.
Please.
Yes, DeeLeeInspires.com.
D-E.
Yeah, D-E.
D. D is in dog.
D-L-E-E. Mm-hmm. DLEEinspires.com.
Awesome. Well, Dealey, make sure to check out LA Live, latalklive.com as well. We're here every week, and this show will be replaying, so you can replay that to all of your other friends and followers as well.
And, awesome. Yeah, thank you so much.
Yeah, and if you go on Amber's Facebook page right now, there's a live link of the show as well.
Yes, there is. Oh, on the James Kinney Show. Yep. You're thank amazing. You, I love you, girl. Thank you for what you're doing to contribute to the world.
Awesome to meet you.
Me too.
Bye. All right.
So, ladies, the next topic is something super sensitive and crazy. Honestly, I think CNN and Fox are the happiest they've ever been. The ad revenues in particular for this political cycle are out of this world. And we all know why.
Yikes.
So, since we are in an election year, Kelsey, what is your prediction? Who's going to win?
Well, this is the first time I'm actually publicly speaking about
politics.
On
the world wide web.
Me too.
Hey, I got a good friend on Hillary's campaign, so I'm going to be careful here.
Okay.
So, lightly, darling.
Exactly. So, you know, I think this race is actually different than any one we've ever experienced as Americans. Mm-hmm. I think it's been extremely entertaining. I also think it's, you know, opened a new path for us. It showed us, one, how powerful one social media can be, and it allowed a lot of young millennials too to step up and say, okay, you know, it's our time. We need to set the tone and really figure out what we want to see for, you know, the future of America. And if that's, you know, Hillary Clinton, if that's Trump, if that's Bernie, Cruz, whoever it is, that's your personal preference. Mm-hmm. But I think
Smooth.
Your personal preference. But I think what it did for us is it allowed us to see, you know, the power of politics and how it's not always political.
Right.
It really isn't. It's going away from a lot of politics
it's
right
business.
Now.
Oh my
it's a
gosh,
business,
it's
man. And people are, and I have to say, I honor Trump for what he's done. He's really been able to get his name out there, whether it's good or bad. He's made a stand.
Yeah.
He has.
Yeah, I agree. Okay, so no official prediction, but you waged an opinion, which I appreciate.
Yeah. I mean, my prediction is that it'll come down to Hillary and Trump. That is my prediction.
That is your prediction. Yes. Thank you very much for that. Amber.
Yes, I can be in alignment with that. You know, last night I was watching... I'm going to be fully transparent here. I choose not to watch a lot of news.
For good, obviously.
Because it really does. I'm very sensitive. And I choose to focus on what's working and not what's not working. And I feel like, I am very confident that the news media, owned by the big guns, tells you what they want to tell you, and they breed fear. And I don't operate from fear. As a life coach, a business coach, I operate from the possibility and that everything is possible. And so for me, I watched a video last night about Bernie because I know a lot of people are getting on the Bernie wagon. And I heard this, you know, again, Hillary was pretty upset speaking about how Bernie she's been called a lot of things in her day, but unqualified was never one of them.
Mm-hmm.
And I have to agree with that. Also, Bernie ended up taking that back the next day, saying, you know, she is qualified. And when if you look down to is it working, is it not, and who's most qualified, I want a president that is most qualified. Okay, this is not a popularity contest. This is not a reality show. This is not American Idol. This is our country.
Mm-hmm.
And I want who's ever most qualified. I don't care what race. I don't care what they do for a living. I don't care who they used to date, what they used to do. I don't even care if they had a sex tape out. All I care about is, are you qualified to take this country from where it is and where it needs to go?
Mm-hmm.
And so I am more, I really wanted to go for Bernie, but yesterday when this reporter asked something to Bernie about to comment on that, he cowered. He said, well, she called me a liar. And he kind of like stuttered and got really quiet and he walked away and kind of didn't even say goodbye to this reporter. And for me as a president, you have to have confidence in all situations.
Absolutely.
You have to fake it till you make it. You have to be poised. You have to be slow. And my fear for Bernie is that he's too emotionally charged up, as we all know Trump is as well. And as a president, as the big leader of the world, you cannot make decisions based on emotion.
Yeah.
And you have to take a minute and breathe, and you can't go taking things back all the time.
I agree.
And so just from the space of experience, as much as I really wanted Bernie, I need someone I'm choosing someone who's going to be the most qualified as president. And it's not about female. It's not about race, because clearly there's prime ministers in other parts of the country that are fantastic leaders. And so I don't really think it's a space of is Hillary qualified or is Bernie qualified? Or excuse me, it gets to be that. Thank you. Sorry, guys. I'm buzzkilling. I'm over here. The producers are rolling their eyes at me like, this girl, this rookie girl. I choose to forgive myself. Thank you for forgiving me. So, yeah, that's where I'm at.
Okay.
That's where I'm at. Yeah. And I just, cool. You know, I want all of us to stop breeding hate and anger and really just take it back to what's going to be best, because we are in 2016 now. It is not a time to go backwards and to breed fear and hate and anger. Like, at the end of the day, we all want to be loved and be loved. And I'm not trying to take a hoo-hoo, like, hoopla, like, but you guys, America's a business, and being a president is a business. And as much as I'd like to say Donald Trump is a fantastic businessman, yes, and if he was running for vice president, or maybe if he could handle that business, wouldn't it be dope if we had, like, a businessman as vice president and, like, a president... The president being
thanks
like,
thanks so much for pushing me to run. I know.
The handshaking and the kissing the babies and smoothing it out.
You've been telling me I should run for a long time, and you know I'm running in 2024.
Yeah.
Thanks for talking about me today.
You and Kanye West, right?
Let's team them up. Let's have a business person and a politician, and let's like co-create and like collaborate on that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I do. Yeah. Yeah.
That would be great. A man and a woman. Why not? Wouldn't that be the best of both worlds?
I totally agree. Yeah.
You know what I'm
saying? So, is there an official prediction?
You know what?
One name.
If I had to choose, I would choose. I feel that Hillary will at the end prevail.
Okay. All right. My prediction is Hillary Clinton as well. Here's why. So I'm a political science major for any of you internet haters out there.
Throwing it back.
Yes. Yes. And I am going to run, just so you know, at some point soon for something.
Heck
but,
yes.
But I'll wait.
James Kinney for something.
But
something.
Richard,
Chief of Staff?
I'll come back and announce it on your network. Okay. So, the Clinton machine is fierce and huge. They have 40 years of backing. They have extraordinarily deep pockets, and they have the banks.
Experience.
I'm giving you like the spectrum of why I think, because this is not my endorsement. This is the prediction, right? Because we're asked. This is not who the three of us are endorsing. This is a prediction about who's going to win. So I think when you look at the far right, well, not the far right, but the Republican Party as a whole, the Republicans have a brand problem, right? And as they've been trying to figure out who they are and redo their brand, there's been a lot of crab barreling in that rebranding of the GOP. The reason why Trump has been able to take advantage of that is because of the crab barreling within the restructuring of the party. Eventually, I think within two cycles, potentially, of the presidential race, the Republicans will recover. But right now, I think they're going to lose again because of the crab barreling that they're experiencing. I think in the general, the American public will say, well, look, what's the most stable decision and most common denominator to sanity? And it is someone from the Democratic Party because of that. And when you look at the two candidates that are there, based on qualifications and the pockets, Hillary Clinton as a Secretary of State and as a multi-term senator, and because of the Clinton brand, regardless of Benghazi or what her husband did in his own personal time, I don't really think that matters. I think in the general election, Hillary will win. So that's my prediction on the election. I'm not saying it's what's right, wrong, and who did X, Y, and Z, but I think that's my prediction based on the way the system, to your point, works.
Mm-hmm. I just really, my hope for America is that if we could drop the socialists, drop the Democrats, drop the Republicans, drop these titles. I'm like so over the titles that everybody's giving each other. Can we just vote and like vote on human? What human is going to do the best, and what human? Like, I'm so over the parties. Like, I feel like
that's
we're advanced.
Great idea.
We're elevated from that. Like, it's not 1950 anymore. Yeah. Like, it's like I'm so over it. I don't want to be called Hispanic. I don't want to be called white. I don't want to be called. You know, my dad was Hispanic. My mom was Croatian. You know, and you know, I think this might be going into the next topic, hopefully, but I was very embarrassed as a young girl. My grandmother would use the N-word. She would use the gook word. She was very, very close-minded. She grew up in Michigan. Her family grew up in the Depression. I don't even know what they had to deal with in their environments.
Right.
And they were very hungry a lot. But I remember as a little girl just being like, why is grandma acting like that? And from a very young age, I could just tell it was angry, it was mean, and I didn't like it.
Mm-hmm.
And I've never really, that for me, it's so closed-minded, and we're so educated now. Like, we're so smart now, and it's just like, it's just get over it. Get over the titles. Get over putting people in a box. It's just be human beings and be an American. Mm-hmm. Can we bond together with just being Americans? We're the most powerful country in the world. Let's stop breeding hate, and let's stop being in competition with one another, and let's just choose the best human for the job. That's it.
Yeah.
You sound like a life purpose cheerleader or something.
Yes, I was on a tangent today, you
but
guys.
But I do agree.
I was on a tangent today. When I was getting my physical therapy done with my therapist, because back in the day when those riots were going on, he's a white man, and him and his wife went and they volunteered to clean up, and even then they were all very kind to them when they got there, and then when they found out they were from the west side, everybody was like being mean to them, and they're like on their hands and knees cleaning up from riots and burns and all that horrible stuff that went down. But it's like, we're all in this together, man. And it's like, stop, let's be against like the other countries that are doing mean things. Let's be like pro-America and against that. Let's fight with those countries. I mean, not fight, I hate using that word, but let's not be in competition with one another. Let's just like all love each other for who we are and what we're American, and that's it.
Agreed.
Absolutely. Well, I was just going to say, you know, a lot of intelligent people are open-minded, and the moment you start to put labels or close your mind is when you really start to turn off your intelligence, and you don't learn and you don't allow things into your life, which, you know, doesn't educate you when you start to close yourself off to things. So I think one of the most valuable things people could do is see all the opinions. And doesn't mean you have to necessarily agree with them, but it doesn't also, it shouldn't be your, you know, every single day passion to go express yourself. You need other people to express themselves so you can educate yourself.
Yeah, agree.
I just cannot see why anyone is signing up for being enrolled in a president that is racist and mean and unkind and causes like fear and anger. Like, it just, we're America. Like, it's not a good look. It's not a good look. Like, this is not 1950.
No.
Like, this is 2016. Like, I'm just like, did I miss something?
Well, clearly, but you know what the answer is. It's scarcity. If you have a lack of things, then you seek that in other places. And
But Trump's got money. What is he lacking?
Well, so those particular individuals, they see him as a road or an opportunity to potentially have what he has. Now, that is clear fiction. Because last time I checked, he's not going to like start writing checks to people.
Maybe. But I hope so.
Oh, my God. It's buying the vote.
But there's an illusion that this gentleman can deliver that kind of wealth to individuals who have never worked for it, don't have the education or the means to do it. So it's a hell of a marketing campaign.
I just don't see when racism got cool. Oh. Like, I really don't.
It's never been
it's
cool.
It's never been cool.
But why is... Anyway...
He's just different. I just don't get it. I think that's something the American people appreciate. He's honest. He really, truly is honest. And, you know, that's something I think a lot of people are intrigued by, is his honesty.
I don't think he's honest. I think he's putting on a show. I think he's a really good actor and a fantastic reality star. Mm-hmm. And I think he learned really fast what gets ratings. Yep. And Apprentice became Apprentice because of Trump. And just like American Idol became American Idol because of Simon Cowell, people are almost look up to people who... speak that way because they're
it's
like
controversy.
Well, it's controversy. It you know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, speaking of Prince, let's transition. All right.
Yeah. Let's shift out of this
let's
politics
shift
stuff.
Let's shift out of that.
They got heavy in here.
So
you know what
we
I'm
only
saying?
Have time for one more rant and rave. And since Kelsey is wearing pink,
we
were going to talk about American Idol ending. Maybe we can combine these two, but
transition into Idol.
Right.
Reality
it was
TV.
Good. American Idol has been on the air for 15 years. It's over. Who was your favorite star from American Idol, or like your top two or three?
Ruben Sutter, because he's from Alabama, baby, and Bama. I'm from Alabama.
Bama, okay.
Went back to the roots.
Okay, so Ruben.
Cross between Kelly Clarkson, just because you just had to love her. She was just like the little sister. And of course, our beautiful Hudson, Miss Jennifer Hudson.
Yeah, okay.
Who won a freaking Oscar.
Yeah.
Oscar, I mean, that woman.
Insane talent from that show.
Wow.
Mine is Carrie Underwood.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah,
she's great.
She can sing like crazy, and I find her quite attractive as well.
Ooh, look at you liking those blondies.
Yeah, so Carrie Underwood. is that I'm trying to think of, but you know what my beef with American Idol always, the people that I always really wanted to win, they never won. And the people who I thought had the best voices and that I wanted them to do a specific style, the producers and the record execs or whomever would make them like make a techno record or something. I'd be like, no dude, like you were like the Lionel Richie rock crossover, and I was feeling that, and then next thing you know you're making like a T-Pain record.
Yeah,
thought auto tune.
Okay, so with the time that we have left, there was an article that came out last week in USA Today about Ferragamo, the famed, amazing Italian fashion house.
I got to stay
house.
At the Ferragamo Hotel in Italy. Sorry, I had to brag. It was really cool. There were shoes on every single level.
I did see those pics. I was stalking you on Facebook. Yes.
That was neat.
I saw that.
Fantastic.
Stalking. I just watch your feed, yo. Watch your feed.
What a fantastic man, Ferragamo.
Yes.
Yes.
Great story.
So the name of the article was The Hater's Guide to Wearing Pink. So first of all, Kelsey, can you define what is a hater? Just in case someone doesn't know what a hater
is. Gonna hate.
What is a hater?
I mean, honestly, this is hard because I'm against hate. But I would say it's someone.
Haters.
Haters. I would say it's someone, you know, who just doesn't appreciate you for who you are and can't accept who you are, so they're a hater.
That is Kelsey Berryhill on haters, ladies and gentlemen.
Done.
Just simple, in case you're wondering
what she thought about haters, now you know what she thinks
about
haters.
I like the claps.
Yes, yes. Okay, Amber, what is a hater to you?
A hater is an admirer in disguise.
Ooh.
Boom.
I like that.
Yeah, I think haters gonna hate, so let's give them a show. I posted that on my Facebook the other day. I'm gonna make shirts. Haters are just people doing what... haters are people that are jealous of you doing what they wish they had the courage to do.
Okay.
That's how I feel about haters.
So, it takes a lot of energy to hate.
It really does.
It does. Mm-hmm. So I think that a hater is someone...
beautiful. Thank you for saying that.
It's someone who hates to see your boy shining, you know, because I...
I just want to see everyone I know shine bright.
Shine like a trillion white light bulb. And
shine
when they
bright
see,
like a diamond.
When they see you shining, shout out to Rihanna. Yes. Then, you know, then they're like, oh, I can't stand. It's just too bright, you know?
It's too bright.
Yeah. So, The Hater's Guide to Wearing Pink. You're wearing pink today. Woo! You're looking fabulous, by the way. You got pink on the inside. shout out to the ladies wearing pink today.
We didn't plan that, did we?
No, we didn't.
No.
We can say we did.
Yes, we did.
So, do you wear pink often?
I do not. Actually, my closet has very limited pink options. So, I think I have one pink dress, this pink shirt, and maybe a couple of pieces of jewelry.
Yeah.
I'm not really a pink person, but that doesn't mean I don't wear it.
Well, what about the pink purse case?
Oh, I actually had the pink purse case on, and I had to switch it out with someone because they wanted my pink purse case so bad. And I said, okay, go ahead, take it.
I need to show these purses. People need
product
to see
placement.
These things.
Yeah.
I get to have one of these. Ladies, these are epic.
Yes.
I mean, it's a handheld little purse with your phone in it. And you, I mean, hello.
And it's hater-proof.
Genius.
Oh, yeah.
It's hater. The new model is hater-proof, right?
Absolutely.
Awesome. So would you say that pink is the new black?
No.
Okay.
No, I wouldn't. Okay. I mean, black is black. Kindness is
black
the new
is
black.
Kindness is the new black. I like that.
Yeah, but you know, black's always going to be black. Black is sexy. It makes you look good. Nothing's going to replace black.
Yeah.
Nothing.
And black men are in style. Ask the Kardashians.
Duh.
Yeah.
No, right. Hello.
I mean, but we've been in style though.
Forever.
Just saying. Amber, is pink the new black?
No.
No?
I think pink, you know, pink is, I love seeing men wear pink. Yeah. I think it's so cool.
Yeah.
You know.
I wear salmon.
Salmon. Oh, salmon. Salmon, as my boyfriend from Cuba says.
Salmon.
No, pink. Pink is pretty in pink. Me, myself, you look beautiful in this pale pink. Is my least favorite color is pink on myself. I've never been a pink girl. I'm all about the red and the black. But I think men look fantastic in pink.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
That's true. Like when I'm wearing, when I put on my pink onesie, it's popping.
Real men wear pink.
That is it, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, the time
with
is up already.
With the Rihanna comes on. This has been the first of many James Kinney Show. Thanks so much for tuning in to LATalkLive.com, where we are more than just talk. Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't know, this is the future. This is called a digital broadcast network. We're streaming everywhere.
Yep.
This is the James Kinney Show, and I've been so fortunate to have Amber Valdez, who is the Life Purpose Cheerleader, Kelsey Berryhill from Purse Case, coming up soon on ABC's Beyond the Tank.
Hey.
My name is James Kinney. I'm a management consultant, and if you want to make mo cheese, then you holler at me. Thank you, Richard. Thank you, Elliot. It's been a fantastic show. We love you guys. We'll see
you
soon.
Our producers are the best in the whole wide world.
Wide world. Salute. Thank you guys for tuning in today. Thank you for all the callers who were calling in today.
Yes.
We had a very active audience.
This was such a fun show.
It was a lot of fun, right?
Shout out.
I can't wait.
Good people. You see what happens when you get good people?
Synergy.
Yes.
And you guys go out and get this purse case, for goodness sakes.
Yes. I'm going to have to ship you one.
Oh, my goodness. I can't wait. I can't wait. LA Talk Live. That's what's up, you guys. Thank you so much for watching, for listening, for being who you are, and for living your purpose and changing the world, because that's what we're up to over here at LA Talk Live.
Exactly.
And thank you, James, for being awesome. And creating this amazing opportunity for us to just keep it real.
Rant and rave.
Like you.
It was fun.
Sorry, y'all. I got a little angry there for a sec.
Thanks, guys. We'll see you next week. LATalkLive.com, where we are more than just talk. I just hope that it gets to you. I hope that you see this through. I hope that you see this true. What can I say? Please recognize I'm trying, baby. Broadcast Network, original reality radio, and crafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we more than just talk. Stay tuned.